cheers from the hundreds of gun owners, gun rights supporters, and activists
USA! USA!
Who filled the General Assembly building Monday morning.
We're very happy that we're at least have another year to work on it.
Happy following a vote made by the Senate Judiciary Committee to temporarily strike down House Bill 961.
I think about my daughters and the ladies in this state that have to be able to protect themselves against folks that want to harm them. And so this bill not passing provides their safety. And I'm so very grateful.
The bill, drafted by Democratic Delegate Mark Levine, would have regulated the sale of certain semi-automatic firearms like AR-15 rifles and high-capacity magazines, and had already passed through the House along partisan lines.
The moment when a mass killer has to change a magazine is a moment of weakness.
In Monday's Senate committee meeting, a line of supporters urged lawmakers to pass the bill.
Time and time again, we have seen these weapons cause fear, cause destruction, and cause mass murder.
I don't need any instruction on assault weapons, and I don't need to listen to a definitional debate. I am here to talk about a life and death issue.
But despite these pleas with lawmakers, an even longer line of gun owners formed to explain why the bill should not be passed.
The Virginia Tech Commission, right after the shooting, in their report, stated in there that magazine size would have made no difference to the outcome.
In the end, a 10-5 vote continued the bill over to the 2021 session with a letter to the Crime Commission to study it, something president of the Virginia Citizens Defense League, Philip Van Cleve, says is an important win in a fight that's far from over.
This was a message that the gun owners across the state stood up and said, we don't want this bill, we don't want our guns taken away, our suppressors, our magazines, and that overwhelming support caused a shift that shows the importance of being active in protecting your rights. I think it was wonderful.
But Levine says he's not giving up.
My concern is there will be another mass murder somewhere in the United States in the next year. I wish to God it wouldn't happen, but I expect it to. And when that happens, people are going to be asked, did you do something to prevent it? I'll know that I have done all I did and all I could to prevent, at least to lessen the fatalities from the next mass murder.
That was our Shannon Lilly reporting. In a statement, Speaker of the House Eileen Fillerkorn said to call today's vote a disappointment would be an understatement. The Crime Commission will now look at some of the definitions in the bill before trying again in the 2021 session.